you abundantly in Jesus' name. And he will strengthen you, he will sharpen all of you so that you will be more useful to him, even in his kingdom and at this end time. I know God has been blessing us, but see, this is the session where you have to be empowered to succeed, whether the enemy likes it or not. You have to be empowered to succeed. And because of the short time that we have, I always make sure that here at this session, we maximize the time that we have. And that is why most of the time I try to limit my exposure or expository explanation of the scriptures. Rather, read the scripture and then we pray it into our life. And I can assure you, your enemy will suffer the consequence. All those that are standing against you, those that are wishing you evil, they will suffer the consequence. You know, today, before we pray, let us look at one scripture. Look at Job in chapter 22. Job in chapter 22, let's look at verse 28. The word of God says, "Thou shalt also decree a thing, and it shall be established unto thee, and the light shall shine upon thy ways." If there is no darkness, you don't need light. But because God knows that the enemies have put some darkness to prevent people from knowing their ways, from seeing their ways. Many are groping around in darkness. They don't even know where to put their feet. They're just going around like they are in a market. But God says, thou, that is today, thou shalt also decree a thing, and it shall be established unto thee, and the light shall shine upon thy ways. No more darkness. No more going around the circle. No more groping around in the darkness of life. Because the light of God will shine and you will see your way very clearly. You know, in Ecclesiastes in chapter 8, and when you look at verse 4, the Bible says, where the word of the king is, there is power. There is power. And who may say unto him, what doest thou? From today, as you are going along the way to your destiny, to your divine restoration, who will ask you that question, that what are you doing there? That person will fall down for your sake. That person will fall down for your sake. Because it is God that has already given you the light to be shining ahead of you, so that you will see your way very clearly. You know, many people, they don't value the word of God. And that is why you see people, they tend to waste too much time. They tend to go too slowly. But I can assure you that after today's prayer, your speed will increase. Your speed will increase. You will overtake those that have been going ahead of you. You will overtake them. You will get to your glorious destiny before them. They are thinking that, oh yes, they are already ahead of you now. But I'm telling you that you will overtake them. You will overtake them. All you need to do is have faith in God believe it. You see, maybe you came to this country the same time as brother A or as sister B or as anybody, and you are seeing what they are already doing. They have got their settlement, they are doing this, they are doing that. Well, I have come to tell you today, don't ever worry about that again, because God is going to give you speed, and the speed that God is going to give you tonight will make you to even overtake those people. And they will be looking at you in front, and they'll be wondering, how did you get there? How did you get there? Because after today, nobody can stop you. You see, when we issue our decrees, I want you to bear that in mind, because we are going to pray shortly. When we issue our decrees, what that passage is saying, that Ecclesiastes chapter 8, verse 4, what it is saying to us is that when we issue our decrees tonight, they cannot be challenged by any court of law. No court of law can challenge it. God can make the government to change certain rules and regulations because of you. So when you issue the command, when you decree, expect that it will be performed, because it cannot be challenged in any court of law. Okay, what court of law are they going to take God to? What court of law? You, from today, if you have faith in God and you have come to this place expecting something, not just to come and look, but to expect something, I decree into your life now, right now, that from today, you will start to experience immeasurable and limitless favor of God. I said immeasurable and limitless favor of God will be your experience from today. God Almighty, that you have come here to have a meeting with, that you have come to ask from today, He has given you authority that you should ask and you will receive. Therefore, that power of God, that promise of God, that covenant of God will work for you tonight. I said it will work for your children tonight in the mighty name of Jesus. That covenant of God will produce supernatural increase in your life. It will produce supernatural promotion in your life. It will produce supernatural restoration in your life. It will produce supernatural honor in your life. I said it will give you increased assets. I don't know how many houses you have already. I don't know how many cars you have already. I don't know what assets you have already. But I said from tonight, no reduction. You are going to have increased assets. Increased assets. In the mighty name of Jesus. In the mighty name. You are going to have greater victories. Victories from today. Your victories from today will be greater than you have been having before. I said they will be greater. Greater victories. Victories that will be open to everybody. And they will know that God has made you victorious. Victory. Victory all around you. Greater victory. Greater victory. Somebody, you are there. God will give you recognition. Your boss will recognize you. I said your boss will recognize you. Your manager will recognize you. Even your colleagues, they will recognize you. They will know that something special is in your life. I said something special, they will know that something special is in your life. From today, you will come out of wherever the enemy has put you. And that's your star, that's your gift, that's your talent that God has given to you. It will come out into prominence in the mighty name of Jesus. It will bring you into prominence. It will make you known. Wherever you are, it will make you known. In the mighty name. You are going to receive preferential treatment. I said, somebody, you are going to receive preferential treatment. They will give you preferential treatment, whether they like it or not. Even when they open your file and they see that, this one, there is this. They say, okay, let us give him. Let us give her. That is the meaning of preferential treatment. It's coming to you now. It's coming to you now. Receive it where you are. Receive it. Receive it. Your petitions will be granted. I said your application will be granted. in the mighty name of Jesus. Policies and rules will be changed because of you. I said policies and rules of government will be changed to favor you, to favor you. Battles that you are facing now is no longer your battle. I said God will win that battle for you. You don't have to fight anymore. Surrender that battle to God. God will give you victory. He will give you victory. You know, we have said it, according to the leading of the Lord. According to the leading of the Lord, that this year is your year of divine restoration. It's your year of divine restoration. What you could not achieve in the past year, start getting ready. They are coming your way now. You will achieve them without any sweat. In the mighty name of Jesus. What those good things that you could not have, I don't know what you are looking for. Those good things that you are looking for, that you could not have in 2020, I say, stretch forth your hand to heaven. Receive them now. Receive them now. Receive them now. Have them now, whatever they are. Even if they look difficult, God is going to make it easy. You will get them. You will get them. They are yours this year. They are yours this year. In the mighty name of Jesus. Every blessing of God that are already overdue for you. I said every blessing of God that are already overdue. You know it. Maybe you are looking for a job and you couldn't get a good job. It's already overdue. I said you are looking for marriage. You couldn't get married. It's already overdue. You are looking for children and you cannot get children. It's already overdue. Every blessing of God that is overdue. Hey, I said every blessing of God that is overdue for you, for your children, for your grandchildren, they will manifest now. I said they will manifest now. Speedily in your life, they will manifest. Speedily, speedily, in the mighty name of Jesus. No more obstructions. I said no more obstructions. In the heavenly realm, obstructions have been taken away. In the earthly realms, obstructions have been taken away. Your pathway is now free. I said your pathway for blessings is now free. Go and possess your possession. It is your own. Nobody can deny you again. No, but every mountain that anybody has put in your way is removed now. Not only are they removed, they are cast into the sea according to the word of God. I have faith. He said, if I have faith like a mustard seed, he said, I will decree and mountain will be moved into the sea. I decree tonight over your life, as you trust God, as you believe him, as you rely on him, that mountain, that thing that you are looking as a mountain, I said, I decree now that they are now removed from your front. They are removed from your front and they are cast into the sea. They will remain in the sea. You will not see them again. No limit for you. I said, no limit for you. No boundary for you. Any limit, any boundary that the man has erected for you that is preventing you from fulfilling your glorious destiny, I said they are removed now. Over your children, they are removed now. Over your grandchildren, they are removed now. No more limit. No more limit. No more boundary. In the mighty name of Jesus. In the mighty name of Jesus. God's will be done in your life. I said God's will be done in your life. Not the will of anybody. Not the will of your manager. Not the will of that enemy. Not their will, but the will of God. The will of God. And the will of God is that you will have a good life. You will have an abundant life. You will not die young. You will fulfill your days. You will not, sickness will not live with you. It will not inhabit your body. Your body will reject sickness. That is the will of God for you. Therefore, according to that word, I said the will of God will be done in your life. In the mighty name of Jesus, I command whatever devil, whatever enemy, to take off their hands off your life now. Take off your hand, your enemy, household enemy, friendly enemies, household enemies. I said, take off your hand from that person's marriage now. Take off your hand from the life of that person's children. Take off your hand. You cannot touch them again. Take off your hand from that person's husband's life. Take off your hand from their family, from their finances, from their health, from their wealth. Take off your hand. Take off your hand from their business. Take off your hand from their investment. Whatever investment they have made, that you want to put your hand in it, so that they will not have progress in that investment. I said, take off your hand in the mighty name of Jesus. Take off your hand from their career. Take off your hand. Take off your hand from their property, from their education. Take off your hand in the mighty name of Jesus. I decree divine restoration upon you now. I decree divine restoration upon you now. Of all those things, everything that the devil has stolen from you and from your family, divine restoration. And I prophesy breakthrough in every stagnant area of your life. Receive your breakthrough now. Your territory. I say your territory, your area of influence is being enlarged today. I say your territory, your area of influence, where you can control, is being enlarged. Is being enlarged from today in the mighty name of Jesus. Doors that were once shut, I prophesy that they are now open. Doors of good things, doors of blessings, doors of good things that were once shut, I prophesy now that they are now open for you. They are open for you. They are open for your children. They are open for your grandchildren. I declare now, and I decree, backed up by heaven, that from today, you will have access. Your children will have access to new doors of opportunities. Somebody, you are there. New doors of sponsorship is coming to you. Is coming to you. New doors of scholarship is coming to you. Promotion. New doors of promotion is coming to you. Is coming to you. New employment opportunity is coming to somebody now. Receive it. If you are that person, employment opportunity that will be better than what you are doing now is coming to you. It's coming to you. In Jesus' name. From today, you'll be making profit in your business. I say you'll be making a 100-fold increase is coming to your investment. I said a 100-fold increase is coming to your investment. Multiple streams of income. I said as income is coming from the left, it will be coming from the right for somebody. Multiple areas of income is coming to you now. Receive it. In Jesus' name. Amen.